Latino Ruido. Happy Halloween. Mi gente. ¿Cómo está mi gente en el día de hoy?
¿Cómo están esos muertos?
Hoy aquí estamos, mi gente. Let me start a watch party.
Sí, sí, sí. ¿Cómo están todos? ¿Están preparados para mañana? ¿Tienen funda de candy para darle a todos los niños que toquen la puerta? Tan, 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 tan.
Bueno,
yo compré
mi gente.
5 cajas de sneakers.
¿De sneakers?
Para comérmelo yo solo.
¿Pero por qué tanto?
Pero
no.
Pero sí, tengo unos cuantos. Tengo unos cuantos sneakers por si acaso vienen a tocar mi puerta.
Y ¿te vienen a tocar? ¿Te vienen a tocar mucho?
Tú sabes lo que pasa, que no vienen a tocar a nadie.
¿No?
Por eso yo lo compré, porque yo sabía que nadie iba a tocar. Y me voy a quedar con los candy y me lo voy a comer yo.
Y te lo voy a comer todo tú.
Todo yo.
Oh, oh. I hope you guys have a good dental plan.
I
do.
You got,
I got a great dental plan.
Tú tienes dientes de más. Ven acá. ¿Y qué es Halloween? ¿Qué es eso?
¿Qué es Halloween?
¿Qué es Halloween?
¿Qué significa Halloween? What does Halloween signify for you? I'm trying to talk with these fangs and it's very hard.
Halloween.
It's very hard.
Halloween. Halloween.
Bueno, vamos a hablar un poco. Let's talk a little bit about Halloween
porque,
and what it means.
Porque Halloween es de que para los niños, de que para los candy.
Niño y candy. Vamos a hablar un poquito de la historia de Halloween. Let's talk a little bit about the history of Halloween. And I sound like I have a lisp. Okay. Halloween, my people. Halloween dates back to the ancient Celtic festival of Samhain. The Celts, who lived 2,000 years ago, mostly in the area that is now Ireland, the United Kingdom, and northern France. Special effects, I like that. Came in good place. And celebrated their new year on November 1st. This day marks the end of summer and the harvest and the beginning of the dark, cold winter, a time of year that was considered a time where people would die. Death was upon them. Entiende? Entiende? I need floss. Anybody got floss?
Let me see if I can find something.
Yo todavía tengo un pedazo de hígado aquí. I still have a little liver.
Oye, tú te comiste ese perro así.
Sí.
Así.
Y the people back then, they wore costumes. They set bonfires and they wore costumes. Usually animal skin and animal heads. And the reason for this was also the treat was to not ward off, but to appease the evil spirits, the demons, to calm them down.
Para calmar.
Sí.
A los demonios.
De vera, de vera.
¡Demonios!
Y después, over time, Halloween evolved, ¿verdad? Into a day of activity. Trick-or-treating, carving jack-o'-lanterns, festive gatherings, donning costumes, and eating treats. ¿Tú me asustaste con eso?
¿Eh?
I just heard like ¿se chupó eso?
Esa es la cabeza que yo le pegué hoy.
Yo tengo un trabajito aquí, mi gente. Tengo unos gandules guisados aquí dentro.
Wow, como bien rico.
Bien rico, mi gente. And yeah, man. Y después, tricks or treat. Why do people trick or treat?
Trick or treat. Tú dices el trick or treat.
Trick or treat.
Trick or treat.
Trick or treat. ¿Por qué la gente hace trick or treat? Explícame.
El trick or treat es como una forma de tú decirle, o tú me das un candy, o tú me das un candy.
Bueno, hay two meanings. Hoy en día, trick or treat, me da un pedazo de dulce o te voy a tirar unos huevos en tu casa, en la puerta tuya. O I'm going to throw toilet paper at your trees or the backyard, whatever. Back then, trick or treat One of the stories is that when you ask for trick or treat and they give you treats in return, that person prays for you. Very interesting. Te dan una obra, ¿verdad? Pero hoy en día people don't pray for you anymore.
People pray for your downfall.
They give you, they tell you, pick whatever you want. Y se lo llevan todo. They take everything.
Hay como un pequeño... But, guys,
I got a question right here. I've been listening to you guys while I'm chopping up this body back here.
I know I smell fresh blood.
Well, you said you wanted fresh meat.
Yeah. Right?
So the market was closed, and there was people outside. But anyway, that's not here or there.
I don't want no home crackhead.
No. This is pretty good. You know, I shaved him, cut him up. He's real good. But, I got a question for you.
Yeah.
People say, trick or treat. Why you never give them a trick? Because I'm stingy. I ain't giving you a treat. I ain't giving no money, so I'm going to give you a little trick. And here's the trick. If you see something in your bag, that means it's magic. Get the hell out my door. Clown.
You're funny.
They say trick or treat.
Yeah.
Why nobody ever gives them a trick?
No, you're supposed to do it. You're the one collecting the candy.
Trick or treat.
Right.
So why no one ever gives the kids the trick?
No, the kids are supposed to give them the trick if you don't give them the candy.
That's how it's supposed to be?
Yeah.
Trick or treat?
Trick or treat. Give me a treat or I'm going to trick you.
Because for a pimp, it's different. When there was like trick or treat, they were going to give her that trick.
Oh, he took it to the hood.
He took it to the hood.
Trick or treat. Este está como un poquito craqueado.
You know what? You smack him with the makeup and
he converts into a whole different color. Yeah.
Necesitamos un plomero aquí.
Mira.
¿Qué? Un plomero.
Uy.
Hay como un liqueo.
El pumpkin tiene que ir al baño. Mira. Vamos a hablar un poco del Día de los Muertos. ¿Por qué no?
Vamos.
Vamos a hablar un poco del Día de los Muertos. Mira, mi gente, don't be afraid to celebrate los muertos. Día de los Muertos has a lot of misconceptions. Día de los Muertos is a Mexican holiday, which is expanding, and a lot of people are catching on to that tradition. What is that? Like a chainsaw. That's a chainsaw.
No lo mate. Lo va a picar.
Oh, damn. The leg fell. Oh, I'm sorry. My bad. Let me close the door.
No me dañe la carne.
I didn't think y'all heard me cutting the body up.
Okay. Don't cut on my knee too much. I like it thick.
A mí me da la pechuga. Me gusta la pechuga.
Ah, bueno. Tú te quedas con la pechuga. Yo me quedo con la carne negra. Mira. Día de los Muertos. Día de los Muertos. Was originally a celebration that happened at the end of the summer. ¿Qué pasa? When the Spanish colonized Mexico, they forced that celebration to move to the date of All Saints Day, which is November 1st, to coincide with the Roman Catholic beliefs. ¿Viste? And so they celebrate that, and they celebrate it with an altar, with pictures of family members and food offerings to the altar. También una florecita este color orange, with that is called
mamelcito.
The Mexican marigold.
Oh, marigold.
Marigold.
You sure it's not Juana?
That's a different holiday.
Oh, okay.
That's a different herb and plant.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but this flower is called marigold, and in Mexico it's called flowers de los muertos. It's orange, and you add that to your altar, and the purpose for this flower is that it opens up that door between the living and the dead to bring back your loved ones. And when you prepare the food, they smell the food. Because they can't touch anything, but they can smell it. Le prepara la bebida que le gustaba mucho. el ron, la comida, el pan, las velas to give them light. That's what Día de los Muertos is about. It's a tradition. It has got nothing to do with Halloween. Nothing. Halloween is more extraño.
Halloween es
cosa de lo americano. Estamos bregando con shadows and demons and witches, pero Día de los Muertos no. Día de los Muertos es para celebrar la familia. To celebrate the family that have moved on. Ahora, there's two dates. Escucha bien. November 1st, mes de noviembre, Día de los Santos, se celebra para los niños que han muerto. And who celebrates it? The children celebrate it. Because it's called Día de los Santos because children are innocent. ¿Entiende? Ahora, Día de los Muertos, the adults, that's for them. Okay, we're not so innocent. Pero, we still give you offerings. And so we celebrate the dead, Día de los Muertos. So that was a little education. A little education.
Educándolo, dándole cátedra.
Sí. Ahora, pero yo todavía tengo hambre. Mi primo me está llamando. Mira. Have you ever experienced any supernatural disturbances in your life?
Like that one? That was kind of creepy. You're talking about kids, and all of a sudden a little girl starts singing.
Yeah, man.
They told me about this studio before.
But
I wonder why the studio
like
was cheap.
This was haunted.
Yeah.
This was haunted.
This is haunted.
This is haunted.
Yeah, you try to do some echo.
They got us there. In the graveyard, you know what I'm saying? And in this little studio must have been cheap for a reason.
Oh, it's haunted. If nobody ever told me this, I would have came in with some velas, some cascarilla, a loki leaf, para despojar este sitio. Bien, bien despojado.
Ay, ay, ay.
Why do
Mike says he loves All Saints Day. Thank you for chiming in, Mike. Judith
Please
Marie Rodriguez, Julio DJ Ponce,
I'm
chiming
so
in, Cindy Rosario, Joseph Morales, Carolyn Nelson, y Doris Ruiz, Star Latin Music. Llaming no. Hablen, déjanos saber qué tú crees de Halloween, Día de los Muertos. ¿Se lo celebran o no? 347-640-3920.
Mucha gente no lo celebra.
¿Por qué no?
Porque dicen que esto es del demonio.
¿Demonio? ¿Qué cosa es del demonio?
Don't be afraid.
Es Halloween.
Come with me.
Halloween no es nada.
I will show you where I play hide and seek.
¿Yo estoy bien?
Do you want to play hide and seek?
No. Tranquilo, mijo.
You're
go back to your room. Someone want me to get you some dinner.
Te digo algo.
Dime algo.
That's the souls that he's been taking, talking about he want to play hide and seek. Hell no. Not with no creepy little girl.
Yo estoy como un poco asustado.
¿Por qué? ¿Te viste el espejo?
Tú me tienes como medio asustado.
¿Yo? ¿Igual qué?
Esos dientes no me no te cortan como.
No, a mí no me cortan, pero a los demás sí.
¿Sabes que yo cuando chiquito, está raro, usted me tiene aquí, me trae aquí a este lugar, y yo oigo como cosas, yo no sé, yo estoy no psicosis.
¿Qué pasó?
Traumatizado, estoy, no sé.
¿Pero qué te pasó en la vida?
Está así. The crazy house, you don't see?
Lo que pasa es que cuando la luz se apaga, como que yo me asusto. No puedo, siempre tengo que tener la luz. Yo duermo con la luz prendida, encendida. Si apago la luz, me mueve. Mm-hmm. Siento como que me jalan los pies.
Pero eso fui yo.
¿Quién más duerme con la
but
luz?
Your blood is not my type.
No, my type is all negative.
All kinds except old negative. No, mijo. Háblame de una experiencia tuya.
Sí, te digo.
Talk to me about your experience. You ever had an experience? I did.
You did?
Once, yes. I did once. I was actually at a friend's house. And we were hanging out. y yo me acosté un ratito, me quedé dormido. ¿Y qué pasa? It was one of those dreams that you're awake, but you're asleep. And you're trying to move and you can't move. Y después cuando yo miré para, I was still asleep, I saw the shadow of this gentleman, and he was holding me down. And I couldn't get up. This is real too. I couldn't get up. ¿Y qué pasa?
Le dije que necesitaba un plomero. ¿Tú eres relajando?
¿Y qué pasa? When I got up, yo se lo dije a mi amigo, mira, I just had this experience, and I saw the figure, I saw his haircut and everything. He's like, oh, that's a good friend of mine. He just died last week. And he looked exactly the way you described it. And I'm like, whoa.
Why he come to you?
He probably didn't want me in the house. He didn't want me in the house. He was trying to get me out. He was holding me down. Yo no podía respirar. ¿Viste?
So what you do?
I ran out.
How? You couldn't move.
No, when I woke up, I ran out. No, esas son unas pesadillas that people experience. It happened. ¿Y la tuya?
Nothing like that. Like, maybe one time I feel like I couldn't move, but it lasts like a few minutes and then. Pasando muchas cosas raras aquí.
Yeah. Me asustaste un momento. How about you, Charles? You ever experienced anything crazy?
Yeah, I came outside and I seen New Yorkers. A bunch of crazy
people. I want to hear the audience. The audience.
El número de nuevo para llamar es 347-640-3920.
347-640-3920.
Llámenos con tu historia. Díganos por qué tú celebras Halloween o Día de los Muertos, que no son iguales. Y si van a celebrar mañana.
¿Qué
te vas a hacer mañana? Screaming, it won't hurt. Oh, my bad. Let me close this door.
Yes, please prepare my meat correctly. I want a nice piece of thigh. I want a couple of ribs.
Let's go to the parade.
No, yo no voy para eso.
¿Por qué? The parade's nice. I don't know.
I've gone to the parade. Well, let's talk about the parade. The village parade.
How long have they been doing the parade?
They've been doing it for a very, very long time.
Which one? The Halloween?
The Halloween parade.
Well, I know I passed by almost every single day that they have the zombie parade. Oh, no, that's just 149.
Well, that's right here.
Yeah, that's just 149. My bad. That's a different parade. A little zombie parade if you have it.
Right there.
You take them out the crazy house and that's what happens.
I don't know, man. I want to suck his blood. Porque está craqueado. Yo no quiero la droga en mí. Este Joker. Pero sobre el Halloween parade, yo no voy mañana. Yo he ido por muchos años, and it's very fun. So if you haven't gone, I encourage you to go. It's supposed to rain tomorrow.
It's going to rain tomorrow?
Well, not rain pouring. I think it's going to be... Listen, you guys are in this damn graveyard. It's a little spooky now.
That's okay. Those
I'm cutting up people.
Those are my friends. They want to hang out after this.
But I keep hearing things, and I don't know, that's really too spooky for me.
Pero tú vas.
Yo te doy. Pero... No, sé. I was there last year.
Yeah.
I like to see people's costumes. Like, see who's very creative.
I like to see people's costumes, too. Pero yo no voy. Tomorrow's the parade, so people, if you want to go, enjoy this. Down in the village, I think it's from, I don't even know where it started. They changed so many routes últimamente. Anyway, go, enjoy.
Yes, yeah, it's seems like it's going to be good.
No, it's always good. It's always a lot of people.
No, but those are the guys that really take their
Halloween
costumes.
Serious.
Yeah, they take it serious.
They
I think they do a whole year of customizing and
yes.
Yeah, I went to the zombie run.
Zombie run?
You ever heard of the zombie run?
That's on 149, right? When the
well, those are the zombies running. Yeah, they running well or whopping or whatever they're doing away from the cops. No, but this one is a 5K race, and the zombies chase you the whole 5K. And the people that do that zombie show,
Walking Dead,
their makeup artist is the one that does some of their zombies. So it is like double scary.
Okay.
Yeah, it's cool. I don't know where they're having it this year, but check it out. It's called the Zombie Run. Last year, I think it was, they had it in New York. It's pretty cool to, you know, run, and then on top of that, zombies chasing you.
Yeah, man.
So, and if they grab you, you got to start again, or you got to stop, I think it is, or
really?
Something like that. Yeah.
No, you don't do this one.
But like, chase me, boy. I'm going to knock you.
No. No, so yeah, so this week I've been watching a lot of horror movies, old classics, vampires. I watched Salem's Lot. You ever saw Salem's Lot?
Salem's Lot, I've heard of it.
It's really good.
I've heard of the Salem Witch Trials.
No, but wasn't the Salem Witch Trials a true story?
Yeah, that was true.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah.
It was based on PA.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. They burned a lot of witches at the stake. Or people who they thought they were witches.
No, but yeah.
Not everybody was.
And if you didn't know, just because they accused you of being a witch, ya tú estabas jodida. Because in order to know if you were a witch or not, they had to throw you in the water.
And if you survived, then you're a witch.
No, no.
Right?
If you floated, I don't know how is it. I think if you floated, you were, I don't remember exactly. If you floated, you were a witch, or if you sunk, you were a witch. It's one of the two. So I know that's how they tested if you were a witch.
Yeah, so but they burn you. They burn in you and everything.
So if you weren't a witch, then would they say, I'm sorry?
Now this. But don't that show you, don't that show you how stupid these people were? Because if they were a witch, you would not be able to grab them. In the first place, they would have cursed you or done something to you already. So, I don't know. Some people are just dumb.
Bueno, we have a lot of witches today, and they're good witches, right?
Well, we have some witches with the B too.
I was just gonna say that.
With the what?
There's a couple witches with the B outside. Change the W to the B. They're good. They got
Some of them are bad.
Yeah.
Some of the what? You found your bug out. What's the scariest movie you ever saw?
The scariest movie I ever saw? Saw.
Saw? Really?
Saw? Nah. I think that was
the beginning ones. The first ones. The earlier ones. Yeah,
tense.
That was crazy.
It wasn't.
I think so.
It was just sick. Supernaturally, what was the scariest? Michael Myers? Yeah, it was good. That's a big one. Mine was...
I just don't know how he catches everybody.
And he keeps coming back to life.
I would just leave that town. You know what I'm saying?
Well, when I was smaller, though, Chucky used to get me.
Really?
Chucky was creepy.
When I was smaller. Because, you know, when I was smaller, I used to see Chucky. I remember seeing him. I was like, that's a nice little toy. And then I was like...
And then he started killing people.
And then I was like,
and you freaked out.
But then when I grew a little old, I used to love that.
El mío. Okay. I have a few favorites, but I think one of the movies that freaked me out with the most was The Exorcist. Mm-hmm. The Exorcist freaked me out porque it was based on a true story. And it was just intense. And do you know that when they made that movie?
Exorcist was a true story?
Oh, you know.
Amityville was.
No, and that one too. But Exorcist, the real person that was possessed was a boy. It wasn't a girl. But they used Linda Blair for this movie. You understand? So, yeah, that was the movie that creeped me out. And then there was another one.
Andrea.
Andrea, ¿quién es Andrea? Yo, I saw that.
That one,
it's based in the DR.
Yeah, that one was crazy.
That was good. You ever seen Andrea?
Andrea
was a possession movie, but everything, the actors, the filming, the production was all based in the Dominican Republic. That was a good movie.
That was creepy, too.
That was creepy. That was creepy, especially the little boy and the Espiritu who was on the horse. Mm-hmm. The guy was riding on the horse into a cemetery in the momento. There was a little boy behind him, and his legs grew long all the way to the floor. He had like cuernos. He had the tail of the devil. That was good. Mm. Check it out. Andrea, you gave me an idea. I'm going to search for Andrea. Do you have that at home?
I don't have it at home.
No. I think they have Andrea.
They got to have it at home.
Rita, I think he's going to search for Andrea. Don't you live towards Spanish Harlem? Andrea está por ahí.
Andrea! Llámala. ¿Verdad? No, Andrea was a good movie. Good movie. And me, my favorite movies are zombie movies. Me encantan los zombie movies. I saw Dawn of the Dead. That was the first zombie movie I ever saw.
Was that the one that they were in a supermarket type of thing in the room?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
The original one. Quema también. Day of the Dead. Then there was one that was filmed in Cuba called Juan of the Dead.
Juan of the Dead.
Oye, serio, ¿viste esa película? Qué volada, chico.
That was good, actually.
Qué vuelta.
Juan of the Dead.
Vamos para Cuba.
That is.
Isn't that
weird?
In support of the Cuban people.
In support of the Cuban people.
Es lo que tienen que decir, si no, no te dejan entrar.
So. Juan of the Dead, was this all in a tunnel to go under the
Yo.
It's the controversy at his best.
No, this was in Cuba, not Mexico. Well,
that's what I'm saying. I'm just asking, you know.
But this was just Juan of the Dead, no two?
It was just Juan of the Dead. That's why it was a finished movie. He played everybody. Yeah. It was just Juan.
They didn't have a cast.
they didn't have a cast?
No.
He was like, cut, okay. Mijo, all me, and it was all him doing different voices.
That's funny. He's going to get the character. He's scaring me.
Wrong of the day.
Bueno, mi gente. Yo, let's talk about last week.
Oh,
Wasn't last week a treat?
What happened last week?
What's up with the footage?
Vic.
Oh, yeah, that comes out on Monday, right?
Vic, last week we were on location. We attended the art gallery, VIC Victory in Crisis, where we interviewed, what was it, 8 artists?
More than 8.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
I think it was more than 8.
Yeah, and everybody had a great story to tell. It wasn't a great situation, but they expressed their art through whatever it is that they were going through. Everybody has something different, and you saw it in their artwork. It was amazing. We are going to show it Monday, is it? Yeah. Yes,
I'm ruido como de hambre. Yo soy que tengo hambre, verdad. Yo no he comido hoy.
¿Tú no comiste nada?
Oye, anoche yo llegué from filming, yo filmé, es que llegué a mi casa a las 4. Me acosté a las 4 de la mañana, a las 4 y 1 minutico, para levantarme a las... Yo usualmente me levanto a las 6:30, pero tuve que levantarme a las 7.
¿Por qué?
Para ir a trabajar.
Ok.
Y fui a trabajar, y en mi hora de lonche, en vez de comer, yo agarré el asiento del carro, lo eché para atrás y me tiré ahí por una hora.
¿Hoy?
Sí.
¿Y no comiste nada? ¿Ni un cafecito?
Un cafecito.
¿Y pan?
Y pan.
¿Sí?
Si me sigue preguntando conmigo yo... No me sigas preguntando porque puedo decir, pero tú estás diciendo aquí que no comí nada.
¿Tú no pizza?
¿Tú no estás diciendo? Como una pizza antes de venir acá, la pizza del amigo mío que me gusta, que amasa muy bien la harina.
Oh.
Y después cobra con los mismos...
¿Con las mismas manos?
No, pero él tiene guantes, pero cobra con los guantes.
Mira,
amasa la vaina otra vez con los mismos guantes.
¿Y se rasca también a la misma vez?
Sí, porque tú sabes que si pica hay que rascarse, y donde pica...
Y tiene mejor sabor de pizza, ¿verdad?
Claro, eso le da una salsita natural, ¿tú me entiendes? Mm-hmm. ¿Tú sabes de eso? Mírate la sangre.
Yeah, that's true. Y todavía me queda. Mucha hambre. Mucha hambre.
Yeah, I don't know. you guys would have seen it scream. I had like a little square passing right by you guys. Y'all don't see it, but we have that high camera. You have to watch these things.
I don't know.
It is Halloween. What's the scariest folk tale you ever heard? Especially the folk tale of the apple with the blades. That really didn't happen.
The apple with the blade, what's that?
No, that never happened Halloween. They just, that's why they say check the candies.
Check the candy, because they put
and
blades
no,
in the
and
apple.
And no one ever got sick or dead from
Joe,
from
they
Halloween
were doing
candy.
They were doing memes.
But that's a folk tale.
Yeah, they were doing memes, I remember. They were like, they put a little candy, and then they're like, look at what I found in my candy bar. And it's like a big chainsaw.
Oh,
they're
that's
like,
hilarious.
This was in the candy. Be careful, the individuals. Check your candy. No, but you gotta check the candy.
Of course you gotta check the candy.
But people be exaggerating.
But you know how the parents check it. No, I don't think that one is for you. It's a chocolate no está bien. Let me check it. You know what? That chocolate was good. Okay. But it's already too late. La comieron.
Eso como los witches. Let me check if she's a witch or not. Let's kill her and see if she floats or sinks.
Right.
No, she wasn't a witch.
So that's why I'm starving, because there's none left.
Yeah, not in the Bronx, that's for sure.
I want to give a shout out to Marco. Marco, I saw it was your birthday not too long ago. Happy birthday, Marco. Come here, I got the vampire to give you a little gift.
Yeah. Tengo los dientes ready. ¿Quién más está por ahí? ¿Quién más está por ahí?
Están por aquí Alejandro Polanco. Saludos, Alejandro.
Saludos, Alejandro.
José, Lía, Domingo, José, Enrique, Cristian, Juan, Charles, Abigail. Está todo el mundo estaba en sintonía.
Yeah, people, Mr. Rivera said, Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
¿Y después qué pasa después de Halloween? Thanksgiving.
All right, please, can we get through Halloween first? I already see. Why is it Thanksgiving like the stepchild of all holidays?
Thanksgiving.
You notice that?
What do you mean by that?
Thanksgiving is the stepchild of all holidays. They only do like a one-day special Thanksgiving day, and then you don't never see a turkey or nothing on the windows.
No.
They go straight to Christmas.
Oh, yeah. They already got Christmas stuff out.
Yeah, Thanksgiving is like the stepchild of holidays.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Christmas stuff out.
Step redhead child. They put them in the corner.
Se visten uno para quedarse en la sala.
We're gonna throw a little conspiracy. Why they don't really celebrate Thanksgiving like that? You know, like put them all out there, but they celebrate more of the Thief Day, the Columbus Day. Question. See what I'm saying?
Very good question. Vamos a ver quién está aquí. ¿Quién está aquí? ¿Quién está por aquí?
Thanksgiving is the only day that people give thanks for the food. Everybody had a win, so everybody say something and then they eat.
Chiming in, Lucy Roman, Millie Alvarado, Javier Valladeras, and Amanda Beezer. Thank you for chiming in, guys.
Do you think that holidays are not the same when you grow up?
No, it's not the same.
Or is it time changed?
It's the cell phones. It's the damn cell phones.
Yeah, I don't think it's because we grew up. I think it's the time changed.
Time changed, and the cell phones.
Generations messed it up. I don't think it's because...
Well, I mean, it's a combination of things. It's technology took over. Our seniors that we grew up with who knew how to party, many of them have passed away. So things, the dynamic of the family also has changed. You know, so people don't really get together like they used to. It used to be a big family event. You know, I remember I used to have really big ones with some aunties and uncles who really knew how to party, but they're all passed on. You know, and then now when everybody gets together, everybody's on their phones.
Texting each other, next to each other. They send you the hug emoji.
Right.
Like David.
And they're texting, and you're right there.
And you're right next to each other.
Y después le manda un texto a mommy. Mommy, I want food. And she's right there.
And then mom, after a while, mom texts you like, bang, acá, que I got something when you get there. Pásame el control, que es right next to
her. Oh, no, but that's always been like that.
Right.
Yeah, it's always been like that.
Change the TV. Oh, you know what's so funny that you say that? Have you ever been looking for the remote and you pass right by the TV and you still continue looking for the remote? Like, you could have just pressed that button right there. Mira, este, you better watch it. He was trying to... Tiene hambre. gotta watch that, bro.
Who is this sending us spooky stuff? Mike Love is sending us spooky skeleton dancing.
Mike Love, lots of
Llamino,
love. Mike Love.
347-640-3920. ¿Qué fue? Really? Oh, is there really somebody in this place?
We got the high definition cameras. We can see. You can't see it, but look in the camera, you can see it.
She's probably a good spirit, I hope.
When you're at Halloween and things get weird.
Yeah.
You know what? One day I'm not going to be working for Halloween, and I just want to scare the crap out of the kids when they open the door. When they knock on my door, then they drop the candy. That's how I get more candy to give away. You know what I'm saying?
They drop, you give them one, and you take seven.
Right.
That's right. How are you going to scare them? You're going to dress up, or you're just going to scream at them?
No, just I'll probably dress up. Like, things pop up. But have you ever took...
You get like in a thing right next to the door, so you're already outside. When they knock, you scare them from outside.
From outside, right? Yeah. Come out from the plants and stuff. Yeah. But you ever took a prank like that a little too far?
I've never
known. There was a video, I was trying to find it, of a mother that fell on the floor and the scissors went up under her tongue. Yeah. And the kids are screaming and everything, but it was a prank. It was a fake tongue with scissors in it. Oh. And the kids are screaming and crying.
I think I did
Some
see
people
that.
Say yeah, she took it a little too far. Yeah. Some people just said it was funny. Yeah. But what you think?
That could be it.
That's too much.
That was a little much for me. Kids are very... That's like these people that want to propose, to like their significant others, and they want to do it with like a cop thing, like the cop is like...
Oh, yeah, that's...
Stupid. Oh, yeah, I seen that. Like, the cop was arresting the guy, and he said, get on your knees! And then the guy went on his knees, and he proposed.
Like,
I would have slapped him.
That's
part of today's generation.
But have you ever done something like that? Like practical joke where you was like, damn, I took it a little too far?
I've never.
What about people out there?
People.
Any jokes you took a little too far?
Any jokes you took way too far and you regret it? Call us 347-640-3920. Yo todavía tengo hambre. Este hambre, perro.
Pero te comiste un perro.
Eso fue un perro. Yo quiero un ser humano. That's for vampires. We don't do dogs. We don't do rats. Perdón.
So when you suck the person's blood, is you getting the same thing that they deal with? Like, do you know what they ate by that blood and all that? How does this work?
Everything. I know everything. I know what they had at breakfast, for lunch, for dinner.
Just by sucking their blood?
I know the deficiencies in their blood. I know what they're rich with in their blood.
Those are white blood cells.
So we need him for Jerry because he could have just sucked the blood and said, you're not the father. Test proven real quick. You know what I say?
Mm-hmm. Give me that job, yes. I'll take that job.
Oh, no, I said Jerry. I meant Maury, right?
Maury Povich. Yeah, Maury.
And what's up with Jerry? Now he's a judge.
Jerry's a judge?
Wait.
He got a judge show.
Wait, what?
He went from hosting a show, from being a mayor, and now being a judge on a talk show.
He's just trying to make that money. He's reading a teleprompter, throwing out verdicts. He don't know nothing about the law.
How old is Jerry?
Yeah, about 102, 103.
He's older than... No, I'm still older.
No, 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 you're still old.
He's older than Pepita.
Pepita.
Who is older than you?
My vampire father.
Oh, so you were a born vampire.
Yes, I was a born vampire. That was like one of those new wave vampires. They gave birth to me.
That's why I see a little cut. I was trying to figure it out.
I'm not very white. I got a tan from the moonlight.
practical jokes, right?
Yes.
Practical jokes.
I don't know. I love practical jokes, but
I do too.
You can't take it too extreme.
I do too. You ever saw the joke? There was a joke that ended with this lady. It said divorcing her husband. I think it was a football player or something like that. They lived in a beautiful mansion. They came home, but he put on like a Jason mask or a Michael Myers mask, and he hid himself inside the refrigerator. I guess he emptied everything out, and he stood there. The mother came home with her 2-3 kids, and they were in the kitchen preparing food or whatever. And so he posted some pictures next to the fridge, so all of them were admiring the pictures and stuff like that. So when the mother opened the fridge, he jumped out, and he started chasing the whole family around the house with a knife. Those kids were hysterical.
I've seen that.
You've seen that, right? And then it said something about that.
He chased them upstairs and everything.
Yes, he chased them upstairs. That was like, damn, I was admiring the house, how much space they had. That's what I was admiring. Little.
Talk about going much. That's much.
Yeah, he went extreme.
He went extreme. Because the mom thought that it was a robber or something, or some psycho or whatever. But anyway, they said that she asked for a divorce.
After that?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
After that. I mean, that's too much. Come on.
Yeah, that was extreme. That was extreme. You know? For a divorce, that's double extreme.
I love practical jokes.
You know, it's a prank that's not going too far.
What's that?
But that backfire that I see.
What?
Like, this guy, he set it up thing. Like, so he got the lottery, the ticket, like, of the NASA.
Oh, that's messed up.
And then he gave it to his wife. And, like, he gave it to his wife. And then his wife found out that she won. Like, she thought she really hit the million.
Yeah.
And then she goes off telling him that shit. How he ain't nothing, how this and that, how I've been doing this, how I'm so happy, how I'm leaving, and this and this and that. And then the guy was like, this is a prank. Like, you're really prank. What do you do from there?
He has the upper hand now.
Yeah.
That's messed up, though.
That was a prank that backfires.
That's a backfire.
That's a super backfire.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah, I've seen a couple backfires. Stuff like people trying to jump out and hit the ceiling. Like get
tupido. No, that's pretty bad.
But folk tales.
When the truth come out. Folk tales. I don't have any folk tales that I was told.
The scariest folk tales I have.
El cuco.
El cuco.
El cuco.
El cuco.
Se comió la el cuco.
He retired or something, because el cuco was, you know, we heard a lot about the cuco, us growing up, but now, cuco, it's Chucky now. Chucky took over.
Now, believe it or not, it's the police. Remember you growing up, they tell you, mira, ahí está la policía, yo te voy a llevar para la policía.
Now it's true, it's true, right?
That cuco is
but
the police.
But it's true, the police, I'm still scared of the police.
That's a sad situation. ¿Quién está por ahí? ¿Quién está por ahí? ¿Quién no mandó algo?
Hey, somebody Millie rocking?
But the good thing, you know, we have to have all these people.
Warriors!
We're getting a lot
come
from,
out to play!
Naomi Cortez is laughing.
That's who Alex remind me of right now.
Oh. Come out to play!
Hola, Noemi, ¿cómo estás?
Warriors. Remember the Warriors? The guys with the bats?
Ella dice que nos vemos muy guapo. Gracias. This is my natural look. Yo me parezco así cuando me despierto. Oh my God! So I'm excited, man. I mean, I'm not going tomorrow, but I'm looking forward to celebrating.
How are you gonna celebrate?
Happy hour.
Is that the vampire's perfect day?
Yeah, Bloody Marys.
Bloody Marys.
You're a vampire, Bloody Marys.
Yeah, I like the real blood, not the Bloody Mary. That's tomato juice with a celery stick. Eso es sopa. Yo no quiero sopa.
But the craziest drink, I don't know who like Bloody Mary.
Have you had Bloody Mary?
I had one.
Disgusting.
That was the first and the last one. The first sip. I didn't even finish one.
That's
I
disgusting.
Are we still talking about drinks?
Drinks, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Why?
No, because I thought you had a Bloody Mary.
There's some guys into that.
Boy,
I don't know.
That's real human blood.
Hey. No, but that's processed.
That's processed blood.
A lot of preservatives.
Just going through something down
vampires
there.
Vampires don't eat that, huh?
No, yeah, no.
It's got to come straight from the veins.
No. They'd be like, Dracula paid a visit.
Boom. You guys are funny. You're out of control right now.
Are we taking this too far?
No, not at all.
So, if vampires work in the blood bank, do they get paid for overtime?
Boom, boom. That's funny. What is your favorite vampire movie?
Favorite vampire
Dracula.
Movie? Oh, no. At all times?
Yes.
Hands down, The Lost Boys.
I haven't seen that. That's a good one.
Lost Boys was very good.
I don't know, but
if you're going to 1870s, then you got to go with Blackula.
Blackula was very good, too. Blackula was very good. I love Interview with a Vampire.
That was kind of just
Vampire
an interview.
Diaries.
Yeah. Oh, okay. So
it's Vampire. A series. That's a series.
No, but Interview with the Vampire was like very soap opera. Soap opera?
Yeah, it was just like, it wasn't really a vampire type.
With Tom Cruise and el español actor.
Wow, you hear that, you know the Lost Boys are coming.
The Lost Boys is good. Check it out. It's really, really good. That was good. Oh, Freaky Friday.
Freaky Friday?
No, Fright Night. I'm sorry, Fright Night. Fright Night was good.
That's it, because then we got to pay for the rest.
Right.
A cry, little sister.
How are we doing with time?
Oh, we're going straight. This is a Halloween special. No breaks,
no nothing.
We're going straight in for the whole hour.
Pero yo,
una hora aquí.
Todavía tengo
good hambre. 12 minutes. I'm still trying to cut this one up. The leg was a little tough to go through, you know what I'm saying? Because I missed the right bone.
They were big boned.
Yeah, they were a little big boned, but it ran in the family.
Is that
funny. I like that he cracked himself up. That was funny. Mira, guárdame un pedacito de eso. Te lo dije.
Yeah, we got you.
Bye.
I'm doing, who's that, Jesse Bama? What was his name?
Jeffrey Dahmer.
Yeah.
Wasn't that crazy? Mira, te va a quemar.
Not really burning.
Yeah.
Yo, burning. No one noticed that Jeffrey Dahmer was cutting up people, right? And he worked in a chocolate factory. So that means that you get extra nuts on your chocolate. I'm just saying.
But that was a crazy case, though. You're funny, extra nuts.
Those are little things that make you want to say, He worked in the chocolate factory, you know, the peanuts, and he was cutting up people. You got probably a little couple extra nuts in there. You never know. Hey.
No, but they're doing a movie based on him.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
There was an old movie back in the days. I don't remember the name. But the guy was feeding people hamburgers, and there were people. And a detective found out by he had a little hair in the thing, but when he went to the back, they killed him. It was a stupid movie, but the whole fact that he was killing people in the town, in a small town. Like, no one knew. This is how stupid horror movies are about. No one knew that the population started going down and down. It's a small-ass town. You know what I'm saying? That's like saying they didn't know who Superman was. You know
Sounds
what I'm saying?
Like it's kind of dumb. Town.
What about Texas Chainsaw? The first one was based on a true story.
Yes.
Leatherneck and all that. Ooh.
And they never found him.
Wow.
And one of those, I don't know if it was in that one or the second one, but they were serving chili in a restaurant made out of human meat.
Right.
And then somebody ordered a bowl of chili, and they were eating it, and they bit into a tooth. One of the victims' tooth got into the sauce of the meat, but they still didn't figure it out. They're like, oh.
Oh, it was because the tooth was in the pudding. Get it?
He's on a roll today.
Yo no puedo con este.
He's on a roll today, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, what was that movie with the hotel?
I was yendo como demasiado.
Uh-huh.
Hey, it's
Cleveland. They can show it all over the place now, right? Might as well. But what happened to the hotel? Remember the one, the true story that the people got in the hotel? Strangers, I think. Strangers or something like that. That they were in a hotel and the hotel people were trying to kill them.
Really?
Yeah, it was based on a true story. Stranger. If anybody listening and know the movie, type it in.
I want to know.
I forgot the name of the movie. They were in a hotel. It was based on a true story. Wind up to be that the hotel people were killing. It was strange. It was a couple of years ago that they had the movie out. You guys know, let us know. We'll try to find
it. Let us know. Call us. Or come visit me.
No. Nobody want to visit you in Halloween. Close to Halloween. Tiene hambre too.
Please come visit me. Mm-mm-mm. Just make sure you wash your neck.
Oh my God. Viste. You know, the only way you can chill with a vampire is if have a chastity on your neck. That's the best way to hang out with a vampire.
So you know that vampires are not allowed to enter your home unless you invite them, right?
Oh, snap.
So they're not allowed to enter your home. Pero si lo invita,
te jodiste.
Pero quien invite paga.
Hey.
Y pagó con
pagó con sangre.
Con sangre.
Vamos a ver. Pero ¿cómo sigue la carne esa? Yo tengo un hambre.
Yo tengo una hambre.
I'm seriously hungry.
Me too.
Una visita.
O ven acá, ¿ha comido en la casa?
You never know.
Tenía hambre también. Yes, mi gente.
So, before we leave, we're going to chime up some Espíritu Santos. Amen.
How are we
going to
do that?
I don't know.
Uno palo.
Uno palo, palo, palito, palo, palo, palo.
No messing with the spirits.
No messing with the spirits.
Espíritu quieto. We don't want trouble. Leave that stuff for your loved ones.
Why would you name some spirits to your loved ones?
No, bad spirits.
If you love them, you don't want to put bad spirits.
No, not bad spirits. Good spirits.
Ouija boards.
No, I don't play with that. I don't play with Ouija boards, no, and I used to own one.
You're a vampire and you're scared of a Ouija board?
I am the king of night. King of darkness, I mean.
Ouija board, you think that's real, though?
Nah, I don't think that's real.
I don't mess with that, though.
See, that's just a folk tale that scares you into...
That is a folk tale that scared me.
Yeah.
I had one.
And what happened? Threw it out?
No, we used to play with it, but we try to move it with our fingers, but we try to make it look natural. But nothing happened.
I tried it, but I just had a dumb spirit. He didn't know how to spell nothing, and I was confused, so I threw it away.
They said if you throw it away, it shows up again. Yeah,
he didn't show up? Because that's how dumb he was. He didn't even know how to spell. He didn't even know where I lived.
No,
I never had one. because of that. It's one of those scary
no se
hotels.
Juega.
And I'm like, no, I'm good.
They make money.
They do, though. I don't know.
Live.
No, we should go to one of those haunted mansions.
No.
Haunted house tomorrow. Where y'all going?
I'm going. That's where I'm going.
Yeah, but that's not scary for you. That's scary for the people that's going to be there. So if your name is Mary, don't go there. Bloody Mary.
I'll be there tomorrow.
You're going to be having suck on the beach?
Yeah,
he likes
delicious.
To suck them all.
That sounds delicious. Yo, we gotta play that video next week. Yes. Which one?
A video I saw. Somebody have put it. Probably could have. Javier Ruiz. Javier Ruiz.
¿Qué le pasa con ese?
No, 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 Javier Ruiz.
No, ¿quién es este? ¿Quién es este?
Video de Javier Ruiz.
¿De qué? ¿De qué? ¿Qué hizo él? What did he do? A what?
Videito musical.
Oh, el primer video.
Pero eso lo vamos for next week,
Oh my God.
Si nos recordamos.
Yeah.
Sí. That was long.
Hey, but guys, I want to see people's costumes. Send us a Latino Ruido or the LDM Network.
Hey,
we want to see the...
Start some controversy now towards the end.
All right.
I just want to do it just because...
Dígamelo.
¿Va a estar frío,
no? No sé, no creo, ¿por qué?
Porque, no sé, ayer viene como un nice costume.
¿Era nice what?
Nice costume.
Oh, yeah.
¿Y las mujeres?
Listen, sí, mujeres, no, let me explain something.
A lot of cop outfits.
Yeah, the cop outfits.
The nurse outfits.
The nurse, the mermaid, the maids. Those are not Halloween costumes.
That is not Halloween
costumes. Those are bedroom costumes.
Exactly.
Stop going in the closet and talking about, well, my husband didn't appreciate it, and then bring it outside. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. No, I agree with you.
Then you're going to get mad when someone going to say something.
That's not Halloween. I don't
get it. That's not Halloween. That's trampoline.
Party City has a whole catalog. Of women with tight bustiers and la tanga and the bunny ears being all sexy. That's not Halloween.
But I'm not mad at you, though. I'm not mad at you.
No, I'm not mad either, but that's not Halloween. You know? And then the boyfriend's walking around with Michael Myers mask.
Ni eso, he's working around with her purse.
Hold it.
Hold this while I flirt.
No. That's not Halloween, mi gente. ¿Por qué? Yeah. I don't get it.
No, I want to see family themes, like a family have a theme. I want to see that. Or husband and wife, or boyfriend or girlfriend, whichever one. A mate having a theme. I like those type of things. Would you ever do a theme with your mate?
Yes, the Munsters, the family.
The
or Adam's family.
Oh, that
Munster.
Would be a good one.
Yeah, well, we can all, you know.
I've seen The Incredibles. The Incredibles, yeah, I've seen that a couple of times. But I've seen like an original.
The Minions.
I like it.
I think something like that. I always wanted to do, we'll think about next year having a theme, you know?
Is that music that you're playing? No. It sounds like, you remember Abbott and Costello meets the Frankenstein Monster?
Oh my God, Abbott and Costello, the best.
Noise while Costello was reading the Dracula's notes.
Yeah, I still remember the thing that when the ghost was upstairs and he ran downstairs. He was like, "It's in my room, in my bed, pulling the pillow over his head." Ah! And then he runs outside. I'm a Albert Costello freak. I tell you.
I love Albert. You know Albert Costello? The black and white.
They don't give TV where he's at. In the crazy place where he's at. I don't even think they have TV. They have TV? Yeah.
What is that?
Al Pacino Joker.
You want to play Joker?
You want to play a game?
Yes, dímelo. ¿Qué vamos a jugar?
Put a finger right there.
Where?
Put a finger right there.
Put a finger right there.
Aquí.
Wait. I think they're here for you.
Right? Entering the patrol post at 36.
Yeah, I think
they have to go. Buscar.
Yep, we have to close the show down.
Poker.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for spending Halloween
with
El Latino Ruido.
Be safe tomorrow.
Check your candies.
Watch.
Wait a minute. You gonna disappear?
I'm trying to disappear.
Yo, what this guy
wear? Yo estoy aquí todavía.
Do you have a power to vanish like he did?
Yo pensaba que tú. Pero.
You just.
Oye. Yo me voy también. Esta vaina me está.